In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve this problem of selecting the top row in each category. Let me show you what I'm talking about based on some sample data. So in this case, if you notice, we have this is project management data, and we have different projects identified by the project number key over here. And as you can see, we have at least one project listing here, AB134, CD14, and this is just a sample data set, but you can imagine a long list of these projects. Now, this is incoming data, but what we would like to do is for each project, select the row with the maximum finish date. Now, this is project management data, but I've seen the same scenario or same requirement in lots of other data sets. So maybe you have come across something like this. If you haven't, this would still be a fun exercise to kind of jog your brain and learn a little bit more about Power Query, which is what we're going to use to solve this, right? So you understand the problem here that we have to select for each project, which is the category, the top row based on some criteria. So we're going to start here at level one, which does not have any ties. And then we're going to look at how we're going to handle it in case there are ties. How we're going to use other columns as tiebreaker. Now, this question came from Ian Bowman, a member of our learnpowerbi.com. You can find him at workadaptive.com. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, make sure you do, because this is what we're going to do for this problem. We're not only going to solve it, we're going to give you the solution, but more than that, I want to give you the thought process behind it. And I feel that idea is really important. In fact, that might be the missing step in your mastery to Power BI, understanding the thought process that goes behind solving problems. And we're going to cover this one in detail and the four other steps in our next video, the five steps to master Power BI. So that's coming next. So make sure you subscribe so you get notified as soon as that video is live. Let me quickly introduce myself in case you don't know. My name is Avi Singh. I'm a Microsoft MVP and a best-selling Power BI author. So let's continue on to the problem. Again, we're going to solve a simple scenario where we're going to select the top row, and then we're going to look at example two, which is slightly harder, which is where we have a tie. And then we're going to have to figure out how to do the tiebreaker. So for that, I have my data loaded in Power BI. What a magical tool. And we're going to step into the kitchen of Power BI, which is the query editor. Let's go to table one. This is our simple table with sample data. And again, our goal is to simply select the top row from this. Now, often you would find me talking about human learning versus machine learning. And in a way, learning Power BI is about dumbing yourself down. As it turns out, these machines are very prescriptive, whereas humans are intuitive. Now, whether you think that makes humans smarter, I don't know, right? But we'll leave that debate aside. But we're intuitive, so we can think in leaps and bounds. So if you show this problem to a human, they can intuitively say, yep, this is the top row, this is the top row. Those are the ones I want to keep. And what you need to do is to break down that thought process in simple, simple, dumb steps. Because I think machines are kind of dumb right now, right? I mean, they can only do stuff in a very prescriptive way. All right, so that's what we need to do. We need to break down. Now, another key concept to understand is that how Power Query works. And Power Query is very unique in this way. Then in general, the way Power Query works is row by row. And what that means is that if you're using some logic or some information to solve a problem as a human, which does not exist on the row, then it's not going to work, right? So if you think about it, I mean, I, as a human, I was able to determine that, yep, for AB13455, this is the right row, and these ones are not right, right? Because they're not the maximum date. But how did I do that? Well, if you just focus on this one row, let's start over. In this row, on this row, let's try this guy. On this row, I need one other piece of information, which is not available on this row. And that is this information. What is the maximum date, right? So if only I had this information available right here to me in this row, then this would be a very simple problem. All right, so that was the thought process behind it. That's how I'm thinking about it. Now let's see how I would go on about it. So what I'm going to do is I am going to insert a quick step here, and I'm going to rename it just so I remember that this is a big step. So let's say start find max row. Max date, maybe. Max date. Let's try that. Okay, so I'm starting something awesome, and then I'm going to go here, go to transform, and click on group by over here. Click group by, and I'm going to group by my category. And again, you can generalize this data, right? So this is project number data, but this will be applicable to pretty much any data set. So you select your category, or could be a few columns as well. And then you're going to say, give me the maximum of the date, actual finish date in this case, and that would be my max date. So now I have the answer. Now, of course, you remember our goal was to have it be available in this row side by side, the max date. You know, we wanted to be available in there. Hold on. All right, sorry about that. So I didn't realize that I was working on this earlier, and I had the column max date in there. So ignore that. So again, if you go back, this is our incoming data set. If you go back, there was this max date column here. Ignore that. We want really the max date to show up on the side, available in the same row. And once you have all of the information you need to, you know, whatever, do the logical or mathematical computation in the same row, then you realize it becomes really, really easy. So now we have this. How do we combine it back to this? And that's a little tricky one, but we can do it. So what we're going to do is I'm gonna mark an additional step, and I'm going to say I'm done with this find max date. So I'm going to go in here, and I'll say end. Find max date, and when I do things like that. And what I'm going to do is right now, end max date is referring to grouped rows, right? So by default, Power Query, you refer to the previous row, and that's what it's doing. You can see it here, but actually, I don't want that. I want to go back to my original form of table. So I'm going to copy that and then go to my end date and just have it point to that, you know, that previous row. So now we're back to where we started, but we have this information in group rows, right? So in fact, let's rename that step as well to say max date table. Sorry, I should have done this earlier. I hope it doesn't mess up my next step. It didn't. All right, so I have max date table, and I have this. And really, if you think about it, this is a merge problem. I just need to merge these two together. So that's what I'm going to do with a little bit of help from Power Query. So I'm going to go to Home, Merge Queries, and I'm going to merge it with itself, Table 1 Current, and I'm going to do it based on project number key. And don't worry, this is what I call a dummy merge, and I'm going to edit it because I don't want to merge and find this step with this step. I really want to merge this step with this step, but I can quickly change that here, and I can say, yep, no, don't go to this one. Go to max date table. You see how easy that is, max date table. And now that merge is done, and I can just expand and get the max date value. Perfect, right? So you can see now the information that we need to make our decision, right? So whether we retain this row, is it the maximum date for this project or not, is available to us right there in the row itself. So you see how easy it becomes. All I have to do is compare these two dates and say, if these match, then I'm keeping this row, thumbs up. Can you see my thumb? All right. If they don't match, then I'm not keeping this row. And in this case, of course, they do not match, so this is going to be deleted. In this case, it is going to match. So let's do that really quick. I'm going to say add column, custom column. And I'm going to say match. You can say match max date. Oops. And I'm just going to say does max date equals actual finish date. Hit OK. And you can see that for the right ones, it's true. Everything else is false. And then I can just say true. And there's a big reason, filter down to just true. And this is our end result, pretty much, right? This was our goal, to start with the original table, but then we only wanted to keep the top rows in each category. Top rows how? Based on a certain criteria, in this case, the actual finish date, the highest one, right? So we have that, but there's a reason why we call the query editor the kitchen of Power BI, because it has got the trash can. And that's why I love it. And we talk all about it in our Power BI tutorial. If you haven't seen that, you can access it on our channel. We're gonna link it somewhere here. But let's see, there we go. So in a link to our Power BI step-by-step tutorial where we talk more about this concept, kitchen of Power BI and the trash can. So in here, the trash can is that all the columns that we don't need anymore, we can get rid of them, right? So that's the trash can. You peel the potato or peel the banana and you don't have to eat it. You know, you can throw it away. All right, so we're done with that. So that was our approach one. Now let's up the stakes a little bit and see how we can do this with the tiebreaker. So first of all, as I was saying earlier, we were talking about human learning and machine learning, right? So human learning, machine learning, well, so I often ask when people say, oh, this needs to be done, I'm like, well, how would a human do it, right? So, and again, the answer would depend upon your scenario. And as it happens in this case, that our tiebreaker is the step number. So if the dates are common, you know, it's a tie, then the highest step number wins. Now, this is in this scenario, but imagine a more complicated scenario. Imagine where it was not just, two columns, but maybe three columns were involved for a tiebreaker, or four or five, right? I mean, there was this, you sorted by the project number, then actual finish date, then scheduled start date, then step number, then something else, and then something else. And in that sorting order, keep the top row. And imagine if this was like based on two columns, five columns, 10 columns, 20 columns, right? So, you know, sometimes I love exaggerating the problem. How would you solve it? What would be the most elegant way to solve it? So the trick I'm going to show you that's going to work as beautifully and elegantly, regardless of how many columns you need to figure out the tiebreaker, you could be, right? So in this case, there are two columns. So what you need to do is could be two columns, five columns, 10 columns, doesn't matter, that you're gonna sort the data set. All right, so for that, I'm gonna sort by project number key. So project number key, I'm gonna sort it ascending, and then I'm gonna sort descending by step number. And you see that it gets added in the M code in the formula bar, so it's doing the sort order. But again, you can do this step and go ahead and click, and if you need other sorting to use as a tiebreaker, again, could be two columns, five columns, 10 columns, doesn't matter. You do that in this one step, which is easy, and then you do this. You're gonna go to add column and add an index column, which is right here. So we're gonna click that, and basically we're gonna go through the same process that we did here where we selected the max date, but in this case, we're gonna select the minimum index because we've already sorted it in the right order. So now we can say for each project, find me the minimum index and we're gonna keep the row. So I'm gonna go through that fast because we have already covered that pattern so you understand the concepts, but you realize how we took this weird problem of that, it needs to be by, you know, by project number and by step number and then finish date, schedule, started, a lot of these, and that stuff almost doesn't matter. I mean, you take care of that in your one step, you can't see my finger, this sort one, and you can add two columns, you can add three columns, five columns, 10 columns here, doesn't matter. Just click sort and it would keep adding to the sort order. And after that, you add the index, keep the minimum index, and boom, you're done. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna do this a little bit quick. We may not go through all the steps the way I did it. So I'm gonna first take project number key, and I'm gonna say minimum in this case of the index, and I'll say min index, and I'll hit okay, and I'm gonna rename this to min index table. And I'm gonna add another step, and I'm gonna merge this with itself. Oops, okay, I'm gonna reset this step back to the last step. So let's go in here. And again, I'm not doing it as clean as I was the other one. That is how I typically do it. But yeah, so with this one, you've already seen me kind of do that. So I just wanna give you the end result. So we're gonna match it with the current table, project number key, project number key. And this is, again, as I said, a dummy merge because I really want to merge it with the min index table. So I'm going to now bring that back. So now I'm merging that table with a min index, and that's done. And I'm going to grab the minimum index. And now all I have to do is compare. If these two index match, right, then I'm keeping the row. Otherwise, I'm not. So add a custom column. Match index, let's just say match, and I'll say index equals min index. Sometimes you have to be careful about the data's type. It did work, so that's great. And I'm going to keep only true and use the trash can of our query editor, the kitchen of Power BI. And really, these columns have served their job, so that's it. So now we have taken the same problem, but we have almost an unlimited capability of tiebreaker. So whatever a human would do to use as a tiebreaker, we can do that. So again, folks, I'm going to pause here, and hopefully this video helped you. If it did, then give it a thumbs up and definitely subscribe. But I feel that I've been teaching Power BI for a long time, and I feel I've not realizing it. I've been teaching the thought process, but I really feel that that's the missing step. So I'm going to focus more on this in my future videos and certainly inside my Learn Power BI program as well. And look out for my next video, which talks about all the five steps and how this step fits into that overall steps that you need to master Power BI. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, power on.